Hi, this is Rob Reyes with the search agency. Today I'm going to go over Google Analytics Enhanced Ecommerce. We're going to enable that in Google Analytics, and we'll use GTM to set it up to start capturing the data from your site and to populate into Google Analytics. Enhanced Ecommerce allows you to see your users' shopping behavior and purchases. It's an easy way to set up to give you visibility on how your visitors are going through your shopping cart site. In order to do that, the first thing we need to do is enable Enhanced Ecommerce in Google Analytics. I'm gonna go ahead and just use a Google Analytics account and just walk you through that. So once you log into your Google Analytics, all you need to do is go to the admin section. So clicking on this gear cog will bring you to the admin section. And from there, you would select the view that you're working on for your site, and you'll go down to an e-commerce settings. From there, you just click on e-commerce settings and turn on enable e-commerce and enable e-commerce reporting. This will allow you to have to get additional reports within your Google Analytics platform. Another thing that you can do is define your funnel steps. This is your checkout steps. You can define it so you can name it here, and so it will show up in your Google Analytics report. Once you do that, you're all set to work on your site and to start adding the tags in GTM. Most e-commerce applications will have plugins that allow you to automatically add the data layer into your site. So it's usually you just enable it, and that plugin will automatically add in the code to populate the data layer throughout your checkout process. But if your site doesn't do that, you would need to code that yourself. And I'll just go through this Google Analytics demo site. This will give you an idea of what type of code that you will need to put onto your e-commerce site. So this page here is your product category page. You can add in the data layer for the page itself, and then also for each product in your product category page. So let me just look into a sample of what you would add for the page itself. So for the page itself, you would add a data layer push of impressions, and you would list out all the products on that product view page. So you can list out the top four and then your promo, if you have any promos, and you push that into data layer. And then if you have enhanced e-commerce enabled in your GTM, it'll pick that up automatically. For the product itself, you can, for each individual product, you can have your own data layer values pass through that too. So for example, on this product click, it's a product click event that will be captured, and it'll pass this specific product to the data layer. So each product would have their own product data layer, and this would be pushed when you click on the actual product itself. Let me go into the actual product. Once you go to the actual product, you can have additional data layer for individual add to cart, remove to cart, and additional product information if you have any comparison or promotional content on that product detail page. So for an add to cart data layer, you would just click, you would just have an event that's called add to cart, and you can have the following items passed to that data layer: the ID, the name, the price, brand, category, and so on. So basically, that's what you would need to do to be able to start capturing that data. So if you don't have a plugin, you will need to hard code this information to your site. So once you have the data layer set up on your site, you would need to enable your tags to capture that information. So the first thing to do to capture your enhanced, to enable your enhanced e-commerce, is to create a new variable, and you would just go through, the easiest way to do that is to go in through GTM, and to create a new variable, you would just go on variables, click on new, and you would select the Google Analytics settings. Here you would enter in your tracking ID, and you can get that from your property settings in Google Analytics. You would just pick it up from here, for example, and you would put that in your tracking settings, and you would need to click on more settings to enable e-commerce. Go to the e-commerce section and just click on the checkbox to enable enhanced e-commerce feature, and then you would go ahead and click on the checkbox to use data layer. What this will do is automatically capture the information that you set up on your site for this tag, for this variable, and then pass it on to the page view tags or click tags that you create. So I actually have a workspace that has most of the tags set up. Let me just jump into that. For your e-commerce, these are the basic tags you would set up for your shopping cart to be able to capture product information, add to cart, any promotional clicks, and checkout steps. So here we have the Google Analytics settings that I showed you in the screen earlier, and it's being used by all of the tags that we've created. So what this does is it will use this variable and apply that setting to all the Google Analytics tags. So we have a regular page view tags, which fires on all pages. And as long as you have the data layer elements on the page, it will use that information and pass it to a page view tag. But you can also create individual click tags, for example, an add to cart event for Google Analytics, and this will capture that particular event and pass any e-commerce data layer variables. So that's pretty much it for in terms of setting up Google Analytics. You're going to be able to see all the information, all the data in GA. So I'll just go over a couple of the reports that you'll get once you have enhanced e-commerce enabled for your Google Analytics account. So to see the reports that are generated for e-commerce, you would just go to conversions, e-commerce, and you can click on any of these reports. But the three main reports that that you can view, shopping behavior, checkout behavior, and product performance. So on the shopping behavior, this allows you to see how your users are behaving through the shopping experience. So this is looking at your catalog page, product pages, you're in adding the cart basically. So you can see how many users are going into the shopping activity funnel, how many users are adding, not adding products to your cart, adding products but abandoning the cart, or going through the checkout process and abandoning that process, meaning that they're not completing the transaction. So this is a good overview on how your users are going through the entire shopping process. In the checkout behavior report, this is specific to the funnel that you set up in Enhanced Ecommerce when we set it up earlier in the admin section. So for this particular setting, we have a funnel of billing and shipping, payment, review, and a transaction. So you can, this will allow you to see how many people are going into each of the funnel and how they drop off. So if you're seeing any weird anomalies where people are getting to the review stage but not doing transactions, you can kind of take a look to see if there's anything in their review page that are preventing people to complete the transaction. The next report is a product performance report. What this will show you is how each product perform in terms of how much revenue they get, how many unique purchases occur, the quantity, average selling price, and any refund information if you're passing that through Enhanced Ecommerce. From here, you can also see secondary dimensions and bring in your source medium, and gives you additional information on how each particular product is doing based on the source of your traffic and medium. So if you want to see your particular channel, you can see how that channel does for a particular product. The other reports are sales performance. This, I believe, is the transaction information, the individual transaction information. This is available with regular e-commerce setup, but for Enhanced Ecommerce, you can bring in other information as well. So that's how you would set up your Enhanced Ecommerce in Google Analytics using GTM. It's a pretty straight and forward setup to get a good view on how your shopping cart experience for your users are going through your site. If you have any questions, you can contact the search agency and we can answer any of those questions or help you out with going through your Google Analytics Enhanced Ecommerce setup.